Scott Morrison will be relying on his quiet Australians to deliver the coalition victory at the next federal election. The Liberal Party is gathering in Canberra, its last big meeting before the nation heads to the polls to reveal how it plans to stay in power.
They called it a miracle.
Only mates can rib each other like he and I do.
When Scott Morrison clinched what was deemed an unwinnable election in 2019.
Unity, friends, is how you gain the trust and keep the trust of the Australian people in government.
Now, with Aussies to go to the ballot box sometime in the next 12 months, the Liberal Party's big players are back together.
Just looking forward to being around some Liberals this weekend.
Politicians and power brokers convening in Canberra for Federal Council, their first meeting since COVID. And their last before the next federal election.
Sir Robert Menzies had his forgotten people. John Howard had his battlers. ScoMo has his quiet Australians.
And some not so quiet ones too.
Prime Minister, Scotty, thank you very much. Thank you for everything you've done.
Aiming to win a fourth term, they've been warned not to underestimate Labor.
Every election is different, but one thing we know is Labor will be dishonest and will be desperate to win.
And avoid distractions at all costs.
Oh, that's a good universal message to give to political parties all the time.
It means some past grievances are being repackaged.
I mean, our Prime Minister had the courage to argue with us.
We've been able to demonstrate to the people of our state what the advantages are of cutting out all the fake fights with Canberra.
The ultimate test for Scott Morrison's leadership will be whether he can recorrect the course of our vaccine rollout and come up with an effective quarantine strategy.
They're the two jobs that Scott Morrison had this year, and he has failed dismally on both.
And that's what Sir Robert intended for our party, to have a clear head, but to have a beating heart.
Tegan George for 10 News First.